Welcome to Friendly French.
I didn't expect it to shoot like that.
Alrighty guys, we're back here with you this week. We are actually at Smiley's Acoustic Cafe in downtown Greenville, South Carolina.
That's right.
We are here with Ashley's friend, Mike. Can you tell us a little bit about Mike?
Yeah, so Mike Frazier, owner of Smiley's down here, and Mike and I actually go pretty far back. Mike and I used to work together as personal trainers, and now he owns Smiley's. He's been bartending for a while, and so I asked him to put together some stuff for us. So Mike, why don't you tell us why you're qualified to talk to us about calorie conscious cocktails.
And I'm gonna sip my cocktail.
Yeah, do it.
Oh, sure. Well, we'll start out with some champagne here.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I've been in the fitness industry for 12 plus years, so from every position from personal training to running training departments or health clubs. I also studied biochemistry in college, so on that side of things, I have a little bit of background here. And then when it comes to cocktails, I've been slinging drinks since my college days.
Slinging drinks, yeah. I love it.
I date myself, but over 20 years.
Nice.
So, okay, so you're smart.
Yeah.
Okay.
Perfect SME for this particular episode for you guys. All right, so thank you so much for opening up your place to us and putting these together. So with that, what did you prepare?
Well, you guys are starting off with a just a basic champagne. This is a great cocktail. A lot of people think that it's going to be really high in calories, but typically a 4-ounce flute is about between 90 and 95 calories. So great way to get your fix in. It's great with brunch, obviously.
Yes.
And keep your calorie content down.
Yeah.
So, and then I added the strawberry, which only 4 calories of strawberry, a little.
Yeah, there you go. Okay, cool. So we really wanted to basically put some stuff together, and of course, you know, Shira and I are gonna do our typical champ or mimosa version. But we're coming up on the tail end of the festive season where there's parties and alcohol and parties and alcohol, and we know that you guys have set goals for January 1, and so we wanted to basically give you an opportunity to still have the option to have alcohol if you have a social engagement. My birthday's coming up, and I want to be able to drink. So we wanted to put some stuff together for you so that you guys had the opportunity to still live and be humans and not feel like you're tied to something that is just not sustainable. So starting off with the champ. And yeah. Then I'm really excited for the other stuff that he's prepared. It's really pretty.
All right, what else you got? So we've got a couple of gin drinks here. We're going to start off with our strawberry gin fizz.
Okay.
Beefeater just released a pink gin, which is strawberry infused. Calorie content's still pretty low. Just add a little bit of carbonated water to it, and we're only looking at 115 calories here. So,
okay.
Real light, easy to drink.
Get in there, girl. You'll love a pink drink.
And it's gin, and I love that glass. I am sold.
Can Shira have the glass after
Sure,
this?
Why not?
Oh, you're so sweet. You already knew it was on my back.
That is really good.
Yeah.
I'm not a gin person.
No, I'm not. It's kind of a acquired taste. This is,
yeah.
It's been a big hit.
I really like that. Absolutely.
I like that.
Okay.
All right. On to our next gin. This is Hendrix and soda. So Hendrix, if you're not familiar, is a cucumber infused gin. So again, if you're not big on the whole juniper berry, piney taste that you get with a typical gin, this has more of a cucumber flavor to it. And then I threw some cucumber slices just so you get really the florals too when you try that. And that's only 108 calories.
How much of an effect does garnishes like this, as far as the scent goes,
big time.
The taste?
Yeah, big time.
Yeah.
If you don't believe me, pinch your nose and bite into an apple, then bite into an onion and see if you can tell much of a difference.
Really?
Yeah.
That's a great point.
Yeah.
I am really guilty of just taking it and throwing it out whenever I get a drink.
I just shove it in the drink.
Yeah.
Okay. Once again, not a gin fan, and I like it. I still like the pink one more.
This is really fresh, summery tasting.
Oh, yeah.
I could really see myself having this out on the back deck.
Rain on the patio by the pool.
That's what I was thinking, by the pool. And you're right. As soon as you bring that drink up, you can smell the cucumber, and it definitely sets the tone for it.
Very easy to drink.
And how many calories was that one?
108.
108.
Yeah.
So okay.
Very drinkable.
Yeah.
Next, threw some tequila into the mix. So this is something that's a little different than your typical margarita. Mm-hmm. This is called a Paloma. It's 166 calories. Very easy to make. This is just a tequila with a little bit of ruby red grapefruit and a splash of soda. We did a salt rim here.
I love a good salt rim.
Yeah?
I do.
I'm 50-50 on it. Sometimes I'm all about it, and then sometimes I'm just like, let me just get to the point here. I want the tequila. Salt in my way right now.
It's really good.
Yeah. Okay, and a variation on this would be with a sugar rim as well.
Yeah.
But again, we're trying to lower sugar and carbs
right.
and calories. So we want a little bit of salt. But you can mix the rim all together.
I like that. And it's not, I was kind of expecting something equivalent
really
to like sweetness and tart, like a margarita, and it's not that. So
no,
it's something that you can drink throughout the night and not feel like you're going to have heartburn, because that's what I get if I drink a lot of margaritas. So, I know.
One of my favorites, this one's very low calorie,
I've been
very
dying
easy to make. So it's just a version of a mojito.
Mm-hmm.
Typically with mojitos, you add simple syrup or sweet lime juice, something that's high in sugar. What I did here was muddle some raw fresh blueberries to give you some sugar and some great flavor in there. But it's just rum, mint, a little bit of soda as well, and just a way to keep your calorie content, your sugar content down, and still have a delicious cocktail.
Getting antioxidants from the blueberries.
I've talked about the blueberries lately.
Yeah. And how many calories was that one?
That's only 70 calories.
Only 70?
I actually like that a lot.
Okay. I like the glass.
And I'm not a huge mojito fan. Ever. I never go for mojito when I'm at a bar, but I would go for that one.
I don't either.
Especially with the calorie content.
I just swallowed a medley. Sorry.
Fresh.
Still really good. Yeah, I like that.
All right, next, the granddaddy, I believe. This is Smiley's specialty here. This is the Harvest Peach Fizz, only 85 calories. Ketel One Vodka has come out with some flavored botanicals, and we're using their peach and orange blossom here. Fantastic. So, a bit of OJ, a little bit of soda, and then a cherry to garnish. That's only 85 calories.
And what did you guys decide to name this drink?
The Harvest Peach Fizz.
Harvest Peach Fizz.
That's good.
It's just a splash of OJ there to get a little bit of color.
It's really fresh.
Yeah, I like that. And I like peaches, but I like it just raw and just eat the fruit and that's it. I don't like anything
peach flavored.
Yeah,
so
but this I actually like.
There are some things that are really hard to replicate. Like I think some people have a hard time replicating the taste of strawberry. Or
yeah.
taste like something just goes really wrong, but no, that's good.
That is very good. All right, and then we have our standard.
Yeah, some basic things. This is a vodka martini. I'm sure everybody's seen these before.
Mm-hmm.
This is a 80 proof vodka. You're only looking at about 145 calories for the whole cocktail with the olives included.
Mm-hmm.
So some people aren't, if you're into the hardcore straight alcohols, you may want to just jump right in with this.
Yeah,
good point.
No failures.
Yeah, and then a couple of different options with beers. Everybody thinks, okay, I want to drink. Beer, 96 calories on your Michelob Ultra, but you can have actually some tasty beers that aren't going to break your caloric bank.
Mm-hmm.
Guinness is one that people think, man, that's really filling. It's only 125 calories, so you're only looking at about a 30 calorie difference to get a nice thick, little higher octane beer.
Yeah.
This is a left-hand milk stout. It's 150 calories, so this is even higher in alcohol content and has a really rich, creamy flavor as well. So you can kind of shop those around, but a lot of times people look at the darker beers and think, oh, there's no way I can do that,
yeah.
fit into my caloric budget. They're really not that different.
Right.
Look.
So, and from that, you guys can kind of take what we've been saying, look at nutrition labels before you make a snap judgment. And this goes for things that you think are healthy and really aren't, and then things that you think you couldn't have, but the reality is you could if you just turned around and read that nutrition label. So, what's the difference in nitro versus
it's just the carbonation.
The
yeah, carbonation method. So it's not going to affect any of the stats. We're talking about macros.
Yeah.
They use a nitrogen-based gas.
Instead
so
of the carbon?
Yeah, the CO2,
okay.
the DLC. So when you pop the top here, even if you shake it, it's not going to really foam.
Mm-hmm.
Where you create the carbonation, as you'll see when people pour Guinness, they let it sit, it's cloudy.
Right.
And then they top it off with a little bit of foam. Same thing,
okay.
just in a bottle.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah.
Well, this was really good. Do you...
I
what's
like
your favorite?
three.
You have three?
I think honestly the first one was my favorite.
That was a very close second, but I think
the strawberry gin fizz.
Yeah.
Yes, the strawberry gin.
I think it was just, I was very shocked that I liked it.
Yeah.
Because I'm not a huge fan of gin. But I'm honestly really torn between the mojito and the Ketel One.
That mojito was good, man.
Yeah.
That was good.
Those were probably my favorite. Honestly, you hit it out of the park, man.
Hey,
seriously.
Thanks.
Yes, thank you so much.
There was not a single one that I did not like.
Right.
And I'm pretty picky when it comes to mixed drinks. So, very nice. Well, thank you so much. We really enjoyed, having you do this for us. And hopefully it will help you guys kind of stay on track with your goals.
Absolutely. And make sure that you subscribe if you want to get the calories and all the extra information.
The recipes.
From us.
Yeah,
the
recipes.
Yes.
So if you guys want the recipes, subscribe to the channel, and that'll automatically put you guys on our mailing list. And we'll go ahead and email that out to you.
Okay.
And then if you are in downtown Greenville, come check out Smiley's. Great music, obviously incredible drinks, and the food.
Wednesdays. No, we have to talk about Wednesdays.
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
Karaoke, live Wednesdays. I mean, you can come get your American Idol best life on. I mean,
make your dreams come true.
Yes.
Full band, backup singers.
I cannot sing, but I just might have to.
And there will be no Simon here to sing.
We have a sound engineer working the whole time, so if you're having a rough night, they can drop you down a little bit. Lift you up to the backup singers. It's amazing.
I need an outfit. We're doing it.
Okay.
Your birthday's coming.
Oh, yeah. I think my birthday's on a Wednesday, too.
Birthday Smiley.
Okay. All right. I'm so excited. All right, guys. Well, thank you so much for joining us. And which one are you going with?
I'm going with the strawberry gin fizz.
All right. I'm going to go with the Ketel.
Mike, do you want to grab one?
There we go.
Cheers.
All right, guys. Cheers.
And thank you for sipping with us.
Absolutely.